Samam Panaya Toshya Nishamya Venam
Bhogi Samam Panaya Toshya Nishamya
Venam Gamya Turnam Abala Pati Puri Punya Turnam Abala Pati Puri Punya Ashyanti Sasnita Mukham Sataya Valokam
Ashyanti Sasnita Mukham Sataya
Valokam Ashyanti Sasnita Mukham Sataya
Ashyanti Sasmita Mukham Sadayavanam
Vratad Vrajad Vrajata Avishata Chasayam
Vrajad Vrajata Avishata Chasayam
Gobi Samam Kwanaya Toshya Nishamya Venam
Gobi Samam Kwanaya Toshya
Nirgamya turnam abala pati puri punya
Nirgamya turnam abala pati puri punya
Pashyanti
chalam
Trata vrajat vrajata avishatas
chalam avishatas chalam
Govi samam kwanaya toshya Shamya Venam
Govi Samanaya Vatsaya Shamya
Venam Nirgamya Turnam
Avalapati Puri Punya
Ashyanti Sasmita Mukham Sat Prabhata.
Prabhata.
In the early morning. Brajat.
Brajat.
From Braja.
Brajata.
Brajata. Of him who is going. Avishata.
Avishata.
Entering.
Entering.
Ja.
Ja.
And.
And.
Sayam.
Sayam.
In the evening.
In the evening.
Gobi Samam.
Gobi Samam.
Together with the cows.
Together with the cows.
Vanayata.
Vanayata.
Who is playing?
Who is playing?
Ashya.
Ashya.
His.
His.
Nishamya.
Nishamya.
Hearing.
Hearing.
Venam.
Venam.
The foot.
The foot.
Nirgamya.
Nirgamya.
Coming out.
Coming out.
Turnam.
Turnam.
Quickly.
Quickly.
Abala.
Abala.
The women.
The women.
Pati.
Pati.
On the road.
On the road.
在路上.
Guri.
Guri.
Extremely.
Extremely.
极其.
Punya.
Punya.
Pious.
Pious.
虔诚的.
Ashyanti.
Ashyanti.
They see.
They see.
他们看.
他们看.
Sa.
Sa.
With.
With.
有的.
Smita.
Smita.
Smiling.
Smiling.
微笑的.
微笑的.
Mukam.
Mukam.
Face.
Face.
面庞.
面庞.
Sataya.
Sataya.
Merciful.
Merciful.
仁慈的.
仁慈的.
Avalokam.
Avalokam.
With glances.
With glances.
带着瞥视.
带着瞥视.
Translation. When the gopis hear Krishna playing his flute as he leaves Braja in the morning with his cows or returns with them at sunset, the young girls quickly come out of their houses to see him. They must have performed many pious activities to be able to see him as he walks on the road. His smiling face mercifully glancing upon them.
一文，牧牛姑娘一听到 Krishna 清晨带着他的母牛离开 Braja 或日落返回时，吹奏笛子，就会很快从各自的家中出来看他。他们必定从事过许多虔诚活动，才能当他走在路上时看到他本人。
Pandeham Shri Guru Shri Yata Pada Kamalam Shri Guru Vaishnavasya Shri Rupam Sahrajatam Sahaganar Ratanatantitam Tam Satyam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parjana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padam Sagana Lalita Shri Shakaditamsya E Krishna Karana Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopisha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastate Napta Kanchana Gorangi Rahe Vrindavan Dhamaneshwari Vrishamanu Sati Devi Pranamami Hari Devi Vanchakampatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Vaivacha Patitanam Pavanevyo Vaishnavevyo Namo Nama Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namane Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Vrajaline Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschasya Nishatahine Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. We're hearing the ladies of Mathura glorify the position of the gopis of
Vrindavan.
The ladies of Mathura have come to attend the wrestling match which Krishna, Lord Krishna and Lord Balaram are taking part in.
所以，那个Mathura的女士们，她们呢去看Krishna还有Balaram他们所参与的这场的摔跤的比赛，去那个竞技场去看。And
the ladies of Mathura feel themselves to be unfortunate because they think this situation in which Lord Krishna and Lord Balaram are in is very unfair.
那Mathura的女士们，她们觉得她们自己的处境很不幸，因为她们看见Krishna还有Balaram，他们在进行一场不公、不被公平对待的一个比赛。因为外面听不到。哈哈哈哈哈！你说话，当然不说了。你说你干嘛？快点，你俩处理刚好。不好意思。
So, the ladies of Mathura can see how Lord Krishna and Balaram have been unfairly matched against powerful wrestlers.
So, the
very thought of Lord Krishna and Balaram in this situation is not pleasant to the ladies of Mathura, who are all great devotees of Krishna.
So Mathura的女士们呢，她们都是 Krishna伟大的奉献者，她们看到这样的情境呢，她们心里面就不舒服，不高兴。
So they're appreciate. This is going to be too loud. So the ladies of Mathura are appreciating the good fortune of the gopis of Vrindavan.
So the
gopis are considered to be very fortunate because they are able to see Lord Krishna in the sweetest pastimes, in the most wonderful situations.
So, these
last two verses, today the third verse, they're very nice verses describing the beauty of Lord Krishna in Vrindavan.
So, these two verses are very beautiful.
And there were there, that's why the first one was quoted twice in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. Okay, so here the ladies of Mathura are describing how the gopis, when every day they hear Lord Krishna playing the flute, and as soon as they hear him playing the flute, they come out of their houses because they're eager to catch a glimpse of Lord Krishna.
所以 Mathura 的女士们，她们就说了，牧牛姑娘是如此的幸运，一早晨就能够听到 Krishna 的那个笛子声。 听到笛子声之后呢，他们就会从自己的家里面出来看 Krishna.
Yeah, they hear Krishna. They hear him coming out in the morning, going out in the forest in the morning, leaving in the morning, and they hear him again when he comes back at night.
所以 Krishna 呢，他早上出门去森林去牧牛的时候，他们听到那个笛子声。 Krishna 回来的时候，日落返回的时候又听得见。
Of course, Krishna is a cowherd boy, and he was all. Taking a flute with him, and he used the flute to call the cows.
当然了, Krishna 是牧牛童嘛, 所以呢, 他会用笛子去呼唤那些牛。
But he will also call the goats.
但是同一时间呢, 他也用笛子呢去呼唤牧牛姑娘。
And just like when Lord Krishna is in the forest at night, he will play on his flute, and then the gopis, when they hear the sound of Krishna's flute, then they will come running to Krishna.
所以呢, Krishna 晚上的时候在森林，他会吹奏他的笛子。当牧牛姑娘听到笛子声呢，他们就会跑过去找 Krishna.
And it's described how the one gopi is only put on one earring. She doesn't care. She doesn't even wait to put on the other earring. She hears Krishna's flute. She immediately goes running.
所以呢，里面有描述到的，一位牧牛姑娘，她只带着一个耳环，另外一个孩子就是来不及带，她就跑出去要找 Krishna.
And another lady is putting on her makeup, and she's only half painted her face, and she hears Krishna play on the flute, and she just comes running. She doesn't care to finish putting on her makeup.
所以有另外一位牧牛姑娘，她那个化妆化到一半，然后也等不及了，就冲出去了。And
another lady, she wanted to come, and her husband would not let her. She heard the sound of Krishna's flute, and she wanted to go, but her husband wouldn't let her go.
又有一位牧牛姑娘，她想去，她听到Krishna的笛子声，但是她的丈夫不让她去，拦住她。
And when the husband wouldn't let her go, the woman, the gopi, gave up her life. She could not maintain her life because she was so anxious to be with Krishna.
所以呢，当丈夫去制止她的时候，牧牛姑娘她没有办法去忍受，她甚至放弃了她的生命，她没有办法忍受，能不能够跟 Krishna在一起。
So the other day we mentioned the four qualities which Lord Krishna has, which are unique to him, and one of them was, of course, is playing on the flute.
那另外一天我们提到 Krishna 有四种品质，只有是他独有的，其中一个品质就是他经常都是吹着笛子。
And that the sound vibration of Lord Krishna's flute captivates the living entities throughout the creation.
那从 Krishna 他吹奏的笛子发出的音震，就是那个就是他把就是夺取了所有宇宙生物体的心。
And Srimad Bhagavatam describes to us how the calf may be taking the milk from the udder of the cow. Young calf is eager to drink the milk from the udder of the cow, but when they hear the sound of Lord Krishna's flute, the calf becomes stunned and can no longer drink the milk.
所以呢，那些小牛，他们在喝妈妈那个乳头的奶，然后听到 Krishna 的笛声之后，他们就停止了，愣住了。And
the deer also, when they hear the sound of Lord Krishna's flute, they also become stunned. Tears come from their eyes. Even the river Yamuna stops flowing and becomes in suspense, just hearing the sound of Lord Krishna's flute, the motion of the waves is suspended.
当听到 Krishna 的笛声的时候呢，也停下来不动。
And so this is all the effect of this sound vibration coming from Lord Krishna's flute.
这些都是主 Krishna 的笛子所发出的笛声的音震带来的作用。
And how, most of all, it affects the hearts of the gopis, and the gopis understand this is Lord Krishna, and they immediately come. They want to see Krishna.
当然他这个笛子声最能够触动的就是牧牛姑娘他们的心，他们听到 Krishna 的笛声之后呢，他们就要去找 Krishna 去他那里。
So the perfection of the eyes, of course, is to see Krishna.
所以眼睛的完美就是能够看见 Krishna.
Because Krishna is the source of everything.
因为 Krishna 是所有一切的源头。
Everything that is beautiful, both in this world and beyond this world, it is there in the form of Krishna.
所以任何的是在这个世界的美丽，或者是世界之外的美丽，都是 Krishna.
So the ladies of Mathura are saying, what kind of pious activities did these gopis do?
所以呢，麦杜拉的女士就问了。究竟这些牧牛姑娘她们从事过什么样的虔诚活动
they must have done we want to know what they did so we can do it then we will also be able to be as fortunate as them
所以呢她们就问她们究竟从事过什么样的虔诚活动我们知道我们也要跟着这样做这样我们就能够得变得跟她们一样的幸运
because these gopis are so fortunate they're able to see Krishna and we're seeing Krishna in the wrestling arena and Krishna's sweating you know, he's fighting with these big men and it's not a very comfortable situation
所以马杜拉的女士说我们看见 Krishna 但是呢 Krishna 呢是在打斗然后流汗跟这些高大的摔跤手就是比赛
But the gopis in Vrindavan, they see Krishna playing his flute and he's smiling at them and he's glancing at them with affection, with compassion.
但是呢，牧牛姑娘看见的 Krishna 是很甜美的，在吹奏的笛子，然后呢，有很关切的去看着他们，充满了爱。
So this is the difference between Mathura and Vrindavan.
所以这个就是 Mathura 跟 Vrindavan 之间的差别。
Mathura means Aishwarya, place of opulence, the city life, opulence.
所以 Mathura 呢，它代表的是一个城市的生活，然后充满了财富。
And Vrindavan means the country, village life, rural life, simple living.
Vrindavan 呢是代表着这个农村的生活，生活是一种简单。淳朴的生活
but very sweet, Madhurya.
但是同一时间又非常的甜美。
So where there is Aishwarya, there will not be Madhurya. Where there is opulence, there will not be sweetness.
所以呢，如果那个地方太过的富裕的话，那就不会产生那一种的甜美。
And where there is sweetness, you won't have opulence.
但是当有这个甜美的时候，就不会有这些富裕。
Of course, people want to, I want both.
甚至有些人说我两个都要。
I want to be opulent and I want sweetness also.
但我又要富裕，同一时间我又要甜美。
But they don't go together.
但是两者不能够并存。
You can't put them together. It's just like sugar and salt, you know.
我们不能够把这两者放在一起，就好像盐跟糖一样。
You want sweetness, you have to give up the opulence. You want opulence, then it means you won't get sweetness. So Krishna reveals how there's devotees in these different conditions. There's devotees in Dwarka, where they enjoy the opulence of Dwarka.Mathura also, opulence of Mathura. But they're different from the devotees in Braja. It's the devotees of Braja who are the most fortunate.
所以在 Braja 的 devotees 是最幸运的。他们跟 Dwarka 还有 Mathura 那种富裕那种奉献者是不一样的。
When we go to Braja and we look at Braj and we see these Brajbasis with their cow patties, with the cow dung, the gobar making patties, we see how they live very simply, we think, oh, they're very unfortunate.
当我们去到 Braja 的时候，看见 Braja 的居民，他们做那个牛粪饼啊，然后生活很简单啊，我们就觉得很穷，然后我们就看见他们，就说他们很不幸。
We do not understand what is really good fortune.
其实我们并不真正的知道什么才是真正的幸运。
And the fortunate people, they will never leave Vrindavan. They never leave Vrindavan because there's no higher place anywhere to go. Vrindavan is the highest, the ultimate place.
所以真正幸运的人，他们不会离开 Vrindavan， 因为呢，再没有找到比 Vrindavan 更崇高的地方。Vrindavan 是最崇高的地方。
So the ladies of Mathura, they are wondering what kind of pious activities they do. They must have done many, many pious activities.
所以 Mathura 的女士，她们就心里面想，究竟这些牧牛姑娘做了什么虔诚的活动？她们一定做了虔诚，很多虔诚。
So there are different levels of pious activities.
虔诚活动也有不同的程度。
Right, there's pious activities on the bodily platform, on the material platform. You give some charity for the old people's home or the hospital or the school.
那虔诚活动可以是在一个物质的层面，比如说捐款给一些老人之家或者是医院。
People are out collecting every day. They want donations. We're helping for the relief for the earthquake or relief for the people affected by, maybe we're doing research for AIDS or something like that, they're collecting money to do research for trying to cure diseases or help cancer patients.
那有人他会请求就是其他人去募就他们会去募捐，就是要筹款，然后去想帮一些可能癌症的人治病啊，或者是就是一些慈善的活动，帮助别人。
Some homeless children.
帮一些无家可归的小孩。
They want to do something to help them.
或是有什么天灾人物或地震啊筹款。
So if you donate for this kind of thing, this is material piety.
那如果我们去捐款给这些组织的话，那是一个属于物质层面的虔诚活动。
So the result of that kind of piety, whatever you give, will come back to you.
那这种虔诚活动的结果就是你给予的，你将会收回。
You give some blood, in the future you'll get some blood.
那比如说你捐血的话，然后你就会之后会得到血，收
回。But there's also charity on the where you give you may give charity for some impersonalist organization, some Mayavadi association.
那另外一种的捐款呢，就是把钱捐到那种非人格 Mayavadi 主义的那个假象中主义的人。
You may donate for their building of a temple or for their programs. So that will qualify you for their impersonal understanding.
所以可能捐款给这些非人格的组织，他们为他们建那个庙堂嘛，然后你就会得到这种非人格的理解。
But when we give charity for the Krishna, when we donate for Krishna, then that qualifies us for bhakti, for devotion.
但是如果我们是为 Krishna 而捐款的话，就让我们能够有资格得到奉爱 bhakti.
What is called bhakti unmuli sukriti. The sukriti means pious activity. So bhakti unmuli sukriti is a type of pious activity which qualifies us for devotion.
所以有一种的这个虔诚活动，这种虔诚活动让我们有资格，变得有资格能够得到奉安。
In Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says the qualification to take up devotional service. He says, "Yesham twantagatam papam jananam punya karmana, te danvam mohan nirmukta bhajanti mam dridhavrita." That people who have acted piously in previous lives and in this life and were freed from the reaction of sinful activities, then they can engage themselves in my devotional service with determination.
那克什那在维亚盘歌世界里面讲到，有一种人，他们呢，前世今世做了这个虔诚的活动，然后呢，不再受到这个活动的那个报应，他们就能够呢，很坚定地处在我的奉爱服务当中。
So to take up actual devotional service, pure devotional service, we have to get free of sinful reactions. We have to have performed pious activities.
所以呢，要去从事奉爱服务的话，我们首先要免于这个罪恶的那个报应，然后果报，然后才能够从事，然后从事虔诚的活动。
So what pious activities did we do to come here?
那我们究竟做了什么样的虔诚活动，让我们能够来到这里呢？
Srila Prabhupada said, "I am creating your pious activities."
圣帕巴就说，是我制造了你的虔诚活动。
Because Srila Prabhupada is engaging us in the most, Srila Prabhupada is giving us constant engagement in the highest piety, the most pious activity.
所以圣帕巴是让我们能够时刻的都从事于这个最高的虔诚活动。
Right, we come to the morning program, we chant Hare Krishna, eat prasadam, you get the benefits of bhakti and mula sikriti, you become qualified for devotion.
所以我们每天早晨来到这里听课，然后唱诵荣耀寄语，这些都是让我们变得有资格去得到奉爱。
Now in the nectar of devotion,Srila Prabhupada describes there that generally people have performed devotional service in a previous life and therefore they are attracted to again take up.
圣帕帕德在这个奉爱的甘露里面讲到，一般人他们前生他们从事了奉爱服务，然后今生呢再次去继续下去。
Like we see some devotees, they come to Krishna consciousness very early in their life.And they take up Krishna consciousness very seriously, and they never deviate.
那有些人他们年老的时候去开始这个Krishna 自己的灵修，然后他们就很坚定的去修习。
Kind of, it's like an indication that in previous lifetime they must have had some connection to devotional service.
所以这显示他们应该在前一生。他们已经开展了这个奉爱的服务。
But then there are others who may have never performed devotional service in previous life, but still simply because they have heard carefully and they've given it full attention and taken up very seriously, they also become situated in devotional service.
但是有些人他们可能之前从来没有从事过奉爱的服务，但是他们受到很好的关照，很好的照顾。
So among the gopis, there are different levels of gopis. Some gopis come from the spiritual world. They're eternally liberated gopis, and they've come to be with Lord Krishna in his pastimes.
那牧人姑娘也有分不同的种类，然后有一种呢，就是他们是从灵性世界的那个牧人姑娘，他们就是一直在 Krishna 的笑时光当中。
And then there are gopis who are just coming up. They've just come to this level of pure devotion, and they're becoming qualified to go back to Godhead.
那也，他们之前说的那种，他们是永恒解脱的灵魂。然后另外一种呢，他们就是提升到这个纯粹的奉爱服务，成为牧牛姑娘。
Because before we go back to Godhead, we have to get more training, and generally.It said that we would take birth wherever Krishna is performing his pastimes in this world, and we'll get further training there along in with Krishna performing his pastimes here in this world.
所以对我们来说，我们首先要受过这个训练。所以在我们回到灵性世界之前，我们在这个物质的世界就去参与 Krishna 的逍遥时光，去受到训练。
But there are other gopis, for example, other gopis are like the personified Vedas. Now the personified Vedas, the Shruti Charas, they wanted to also take part in Lord Krishna's pastimes.
那有一类的牧人姑娘，她们是这个维达经的人格化，她们也想能够去进入 Krishna 的逍遥时光。
Yeah, they're the personified Vedas. They wanted to understand Krishna's personal feature and to take part in his pastimes. So they got the benediction that they could also take part as gopis and take part in Lord Krishna's
pastimes.
But and then there are other gopis who in their previous life they were great sages in the pastimes of Lord Ramachandra. And these great sages had seen Lord Ramachandra in the forest and they became attracted to him and they desired to enjoy an amorous relationship with him.
那他们在森林里面遇见了Ramachandra这些伟大的圣者，然后他们呢，有这个愿望呢，希望呢能够跟Krishna一起去享受这个甜美的时光。
But of course, Lord Ramachandra had vowed that he would only take one wife, and that was Sita, and after Mother Sita, no other woman. He had the vow, Eka Patni Vrat, only one wife. He would only enjoy with one woman, and didn't.
一位的妻子，他不能够有其他的妻子情人。So
Lord Ramachandra told them that you can't have an amorous relationship with Lord Krishna, you can take birth as gopis, and in this way you can have contact.
所以Ramachandra说，这一辈子不行，但是呢，你可以下一辈子能够呢去就是投。So
we see there are different kinds of gopis among the gopis who are there in Lord Krishna's pastimes. It's not that they're all coming from the spiritual world.
所以在不省的逍遥时光里面有不同种类的牧牛姑娘，不是说全部都是来自灵性世界的。
But certainly they've all performed pious activities of one kind and another. And therefore they're able to see Lord Krishna and they're able to hear him play the flute and they're able to enjoy his loving glances on them.
所以因此他们能够有这样的幸运，能够看见Krishna，听到他的笛子声。
Just like sometimes famous movie stars come and they're, you know, it's very attractive. People, oh, I want to see that person, you know, and many people all come to see. They were telling me how that some man opened the new jeweler shop there, goldsmith shop, and he invited this something Khan, what's the name that movie star?
Shahrukh Khan.
Shahrukh Khan. A very, I mean, I've never heard of him, but you know, everybody else, all the Indian people, of course, knew him. And when they all heard, you know, the whole place, the whole town, the whole downtown became packed, and the police had to close off, no more traffic, and all the streets were blocked, people everywhere. Everybody just wanted to have a glimpse of this Shah Rukh Khan, you know, movie star.
他在那个杜拜有一个珠宝店开张，然后，那个有一个请了一个明星，那个电影明星Shah Rukh Khan，然后来就是开幕，然后就是全那个城市的人，他们都全部涌过去，然后那个交通又停止啊，瘫痪。
You know,
so
people consider themselves so fortunate and say, I saw him. But who is actually fortunate here? The gopis of Vrindavan, that they can see Krishna every day. And we also are fortunate because we can come and see the deities every day. And there are many devotees like that who will come every day to see the deity, and they understand this is real auspiciousness to see the form of the Lord. There was the one man, he vowed he would not take his meal, he would not take any food until he first of all saw the Lord. And he was living in Ayodhya, he would go to Ayodhya, he would go to the palace of Lord Ramachandra, and he would see Lord Ramachandra and offer his obeisances. And after offering his obeisances, only then he would go home and take his food.
那有一个男士，他住在那个阿尤亚，他娶了一个侍人，就是说，除非他见了主，不然的话呢，他不会吃任何的东西。所以他每天早上先去顶接Ramachandra，主Ramachandra，然后才回家吃东西。
But sometimes Lord Ramachandra would go out of his palace, he would go around the kingdom, and he would not be there. And the Brahman would come, and he wouldn't be able to see Lord Ramachandra, so he would fast that day.
那这位婆罗门，他就许了这个誓言，但是有时候主Ramachandra他不在那个宫殿里面，可能在其他的地方，然后他就看不见了主Ramachandra，他就整天就会断食。And
for several days it happened like that. The Brahmana was fasting.
那好几天都发生这样的事情，他好几天都断食。
And when Lord Ramachandra came back and he heard about this, he was very upset, and he called the Brahman. And he gave the Brahman, he said, you take, he gave him a deity, which was the form of Lord Ramachandra. And he said, you take my deity and you worship this. And he said, you offer obeisance, he says, and this way you don't need to fast. So even today there are many devotees like that in places like Jaipur. They will come every day to see Govindaji and offer their obeisances. Even they're not well, they have a fever, still they will come. So this is devotion to
Krishna.
Okay, any question? General Vyasa Prabhu? Anything? Any comments? Anybody? Any questions? Yes, nothing.
You mentioned that wealth and sweetness cannot be together in a person. But Srila Prabhupada is
Well, the opulence of pure devotional service is that sweetness. Pure devotee, Prabhupada was not enjoying a lot of opulence. He was traveling economy.
他是做那个经济级的。
One time, one devotee got traveled by the business class seat on the flight.
那有一次，有一位先生安排了这个商务舱。
And Prabhupada didn't like it. He said, "No, I don't want it." He said, "Why do you waste money like this? Just give me the economy, regular ticket."
那圣爸爸就不喜欢，他说，你就是给我买一张普通舱的那个机票就可以了，为什么要浪费这些钱？
We see Sudama Brahman, after he went to Dwarka, Krishna had given so much opulence. But Sudama accepted it all in the mood of renunciation.
And
then he quickly went back to Sudama.And so devotee is not attached to material
objects.
Some people think they can't do devotional service unless they have certain facilities, certain conditions. But devotional service doesn't depend on material situation.
不取决于一个人的他的物质的情况。
Whatever situation the devotee is placed in by the arrangement of Krishna, the devotee accepts it and thus goes on with his service.
那所有奉献者他们面对的处境，他们都会接受，然后呢，把它视为是奉爱的服务。
And the devotee accepts opulence for the service of Krishna, not for his sense gratification.
那奉献者接受富裕的话，也是。为了服务，而不是为了自己的感官享乐。
Just like the king has a palace, and the king is living in the palace, his servants are also living there, but his servants are living there to give service to the king.
就好像国王他住在那个皇宫，那他的仆人也是住在皇宫，因为仆人呢来服务国王。
So the same way the devotees enjoy the opulence of Krishna.
所以同样的，这样的方式去。享用这个反复语。
Okay, Hare Krishna, Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai.